So far, the aggregation methods we are used to seeing are, for example, a numerical method mode and string aggregation method unique concatenate. In this video, we will introduce more complex aggregation methods like statistical measures or a method working on a column of type date and time. The dataset we use in this video contains customer data. In this demo, we focus on the following columns: sentiment analysis, including 5 different attitude categories, gender with 2 values male and female, the numerical column estimated yearly income, products, including 5 different investment products, and the birthday column of type date and time. In the first example, we calculate the date range on a column with date values, which is the birthday column. In this pivot table, we calculate the age difference in days between the youngest and oldest customers within each group. Let's open the configuration dialog and take a look at the settings required for this pivot table. First, we include the product column in the set of group columns. Next, we include the sentiment analysis column in the set of pivot columns. In the manual aggregation tab, we select the birthday column, which contains dates of birth of customers. If we now open the menu for aggregation methods, we see different options from the previous examples due to the column type date and time. We select the aggregation method date range day because we want to calculate the date range for each group of customers in days rather than milliseconds. Our last example concerns 2 statistical aggregation methods, mean and standard deviation. We calculate the mean and standard deviation of the yearly income according to sentiment and gender, as shown in this pivot table. Here, the row IDs are the different sentiments. There are 2 columns for each gender because we have 2 aggregation methods, mean and standard deviation. Let's take a look at the settings required for this pivot table. We include the sentiment analysis column in the set of group columns. Then we include the gender column in the set of pivot columns. In the manual aggregation tab, we select the estimated yearly income column. The aggregation method we apply is mean. Because we apply 2 aggregation methods to the same column, we select the column estimated yearly income once more. This time we select the aggregation method standard deviation. As you can see though, in the menu for aggregation methods, there are other statistical aggregation methods available, like kurtosis, skewness, variance, and some more. We can also see here that the option to include missing values is not available for the calculation of mean and standard deviation. That's because some aggregation methods, like mean and variance, cannot include missing values in their calculation. In this video, we have introduced some advanced layouts of the pivot table and shown how to set the pivoting node to achieve them. We have applied several aggregation methods for different data types. And finally, we have shown that some aggregation methods automatically disable the option to include missing values.